Get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean. Brett Summers. Dick Martin. From Chips, Breanne Leary. Phil Daly. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 79. And now, here's the star of Match Game 79, Gene Regan.
Yeah.
Right here is a...
This is very Eastern school.
Gene, yes.
Hey, like,
wow.
Gene, but not school. On you.
$2 on number four.
No, I'm sorry. Now, here we've got Ron Tislow and Essie Paul.
I just noticed
that. And we're in the middle of round two. Now, because we got out of sequence, Essie Paul goes next. And this is your last shot at it here. Essie, the way it is, you need two to tie and three to win.
Easy.
Two
here we
tie
go.
And piece three of cake.
Sally, the secretary, said.
Uh-huh.
Or Twinkie, whatever.
My boss is really strange.
Strange.
All together, we rehearse them or throw them out. One more time. Sally, the secretary, said, my boss is...
How strange...
No.
What is one of the essentials of being
Time.
A... Oh, thank you. Sally, the secretary, said, my boss is really strange.
How strange is he?
Okay. A minus. I don't have any plants in my office, so while I was on vacation, he watered my blank. All right. Sally, the secretary, said, my boss is really strange. I don't have any plants in my office, so while I was on vacation, he watered my blank.
Typewriter.
Typewriter's good. That was the nearest handy thing, the typewriter.
I was thinking of a hydrangea bush.
Oh, really?
Howsomever, I wrote typewriter.
Oh, very good for you.
A hydrangea.
Hydrangea
bush.
They're beautiful. I have one in my yard. Hello
they
there.
They grow beautifully by
yes.
the ocean.
Big
well,
blossoms.
There's your shorthand, and then there's your typewriter.
All right. Fourth tie, 2-2. One more will win the game, Essie.
Watered her pad.
Her pad.
That's a double. That's it goes either way.
Oh, now wait a minute.
Her pad and her pad.
Oh, the pad. You mean under the desk, the thing.
The memo.
Oh, the pad, the memo pad. Oh, I see.
Sure.
The shorthand pad.
Shorthand pad or the pad where she lives.
The short person, Breanne.
The plane, boss.
Yes, go ahead.
I like the ladies.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
You don't like that?
Do it. Typewriter.
Thank you, Gene. It was a pleasure being here.
We're going to send some gifts your way. We've got, you know, ladies' underwear and all kinds of wonderful things. You're going to love it. There goes Ron Tislow. Let's do that business of the house. Here's Essie Paul. She's got $100. Now she's going to try for more money. The big money here in the Big Money Super Match. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, Essie. And we said to those people in this very room, we said, write down your best answer to this. Blank Giants. If you give us the answer that they wrote down most often, we give you $500. If you give us the answer they wrote down second most often, you get $250. And then for matching the third most popular response, $100. And three of the dingbats will give you some assistance here.
Fanny?
Well, you know, you have to study the newspapers to get these answers correct. I'll dip into my background and say New York Giants.
New York Giants.
Is that right? Are they?
I would say you're a little old for that. You're New York Giants. The San Francisco Giants.
Yeah.
How about that?
San Francisco Giants. Fanny, haven't you heard they moved to San Francisco?
They moved in 1941 or something.
Well, they moved to San Francisco.
They didn't ask me. You need something to happen?
And you chose me.
Who? What do you got
there,
for you?
There, the great Emmy-winning award television show, Land of the Giants.
Land of the Giants.
still think New York Giants.
Now, those are the three. New York Giants, San Francisco Giants, and Land of the Giants. Don't fight, children.
Okay, Dad.
Now, you can choose one of those or throw them all out. Give us one of your own.
I'm going to go with Bill, San Francisco Giants.
Oh, no!
San
Francisco
Giants. No. It's going to be New York Giants.
You think it's going to be New York?
Yes.
What do you think it's going to be?
Maybe I should change. Can we both change together?
No, 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 no.
Minnesota.
They're getting hostile out there.
They are.
I think we should go with the crowd.
She wants the San Francisco Giants. Is it under the $100 number? Jolly Green Giant.
That's Corn Giant.
I know it, but the audience is a little goofy that day. No, what do you mean that day? Okay. Now let's go up the ladder and look at the next one, please.
We're going to get it. We're going to get it.
You think it's going to be
there?
It's going to be Land.
And we can fool the audience on this one, right?
Okay.
You're wrong.
That's right. Now, you said New York, and he's been saying San Francisco. Now, if it's San Francisco now, you're going to get fooled.
Sure, now you don't like New York because it's up there already, right? Yeah,
right.
Right. Now you don't like it.
All right, let's see the big one, please. Yes. Yeah! Okay, cut. One quick boo for the audience. Right. Together. Boo! Cut. Okay. I win the $500. Means at least you play for us 10 times that amount or $5,000. But you get a chance to spin the wheel as everyone else does. And if you get a lucky spin of the wheel, you'll be playing for $10,000. And we'll all root for a double. Here we go.
Double!
All right, Essie. Dick Martin.
Yes.
It's on you. Yeah.
Would it stay there?
It stayed there.
Ah.
Right there.
It's not a double, though, is it?
That's not a double.
Which way is it?
It's.
My eyes are going.
Who's on first? What's on
first? Okay. No, there it is. It's Dick Martin, and it's $5,000 right there in the blue dot facing me, if you please, and good luck to you. This is it. Fail blank. F-A-I-L blank. Fail blank. Okay, now all we want is the answer that Dick has written on the card. If you do that, you get $5,000. Fail blank.
Exams. All I can think of.
Can't think of anything. There's one answer that leaped into my mind instantly. Did it leap into your mind?
I'm afraid so. I put down fail safe.
Fail safe, yeah. You didn't think of that at all. You think of that? Fail safe. Yeah. Well, I'm sorry you didn't get the money. Yes, you've got $600, and you're going to meet another player, so let's meet Avis McDermott right now. So you're Avis McDermott.
Yes, sir.
What's your real name?
Hertz.
Hertz McDermott.
Yeah.
I guess people give you a hard time about your name, but we're not going to say anything at all about it, Avis.
Thank
we welcome you and wish you the best of luck, and we want to get acquainted with you, find out where you're from, and what you do with your life. How do you fill your days?
Oh,
she
I'm
tries
from Huntington
harder.
Beach.
What?
Oh, I'm from Huntington Beach, and I like to ski and play racquetball, and I'm into photography, and I have a handsome boyfriend.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
Well, the guy's going, who cares?
He's here, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
She's beautiful.
Watching me.
Get rid of
him, Jarvis. We'll be the judge of that. Where is he?
Which
you
one?
You lucky devil. She's so
cute. Oh, the guy with the beard. Oh, he is darling looking.
Where is he? When I put my glasses on, I'll be the judge of
where
that.
Is yeah. Where is do I meet your approval or not?
I kind of go for him myself, Avis.
Where is he?
Which one?
I can't find him.
Where are you?
There's a fellow right here with a beard.
Where?
Down at first row.
Hey,
first row, right there. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, Avis, good luck.
Thank
you. Have a choice here of A or B?
A little iffy.
I'll go A.
You go with A? All right. Faye Ray said.
Ah. I know Faye Ray.
She said, you know how some people throw salt over their shoulder for good luck?
Yes.
Well, King Kong is so big for good luck, he throws blank over his shoulder. She knew him well, as you know.
I had to see King Kong four times before I realized that Fay Wray wasn't really in love with him.
Fay Wray said. You know how some people throw salt? You know who she was.
Yes.
Yeah. It's how some people throw salt over their shoulder for good luck. She said, well, King Kong is so big for good luck, he throws blank over his shoulder.
A boulder.
Or boulders?
Boulders.
Thank you. She looks like Faye Ray.
Yes. But... Well, I guess what they're after here, Avis, is something associated with King Kong and Faye Ray.
Yes.
Salt.
Try harder, Avis.
Please try harder.
I said rock salt.
Rock salt. Okay. That would be difficult to figure. What do you got there?
Well, it's not for you to ask.
Oh, I mean, really?
I said you threw the whole mine.
The whole salt mine?
Salt mine.
Yes, dear.
Okay,
as
right.
In salt, like, that's where they get the salt?
That's
in
the salt mine. Get rid
of it. Through Salt Lake, or?
Salt Lake, yeah. Whole thing. Powerful. Avis, you got the idea now. King Kong is so big, for good luck, he throws.
Brett and I are just being totally cosmic. Salt mine.
Salt mine. Okay.
We've met.
I went one farther than Dick. I said he threw Salt Lake City over there. The whole
Salt Lake City.
The Lake Anderson.
That includes the lake.
Yeah. Lake Anderson.
What came to your little mind, Miss Fanny?
Little?
Now you got
little?
It.
I said he threw Miami Beach over his shoulder.
Miami Beach. Yeah.
I don't get
okay.
It.
Okay. All right. Now, we'll have a question for you in a moment or so. Right now, we have this for you. Here it is. Okay. Essie, this is all yours. One archaeologist said to another, "This mummy can't be for real. Take a look. Since when does a mummy wear a blank?" Two archaeologists are speaking to each other. All right.
Quiet. Just writing to my wife, that's all.
Okay. Let her know. Essie, one archaeologist said to another, "This mummy can't be for real. Take a look. Since when does a mummy wear a blank?"
I have to go with this crowd and thinking that it's a girl and say brassiere.
Since when did the mummy wear a brassiere? She thought you're a racy bunch and you would all say things like brassiere.
Well, you've heard of that book by Mr. Hoving from the Metro, the Untold Mystery of King Tut?
Yes.
He was the one that wore the bra.
Aha!
Very strange.
Tutankhamun wore a bra. No wonder he died at 19. I don't know what that means.
He keeled over
doesn't
one day.
Doesn't make one shred of sense.
That's right.
I said he wore a girdle.
A girdle?
Yeah.
Take a look. All right.
I'm partly right. A bikini.
A bikini. Okay. This mummy can't be for real. Take a look. Since when does a mummy wear a...
This mummy was obviously a jock. An ace bandage.
An ace bandage.
That's funny.
I think that's a wonderful
that's
answer.
Yay,
and
excited.
Amusing, too. Don't
you? Sorry,
okay.
I didn't mack you, Essie.
You're embarrassed.
Silicone boobs?
Since when does a mummy wear...
Wrong, but not funny.
Well, I'm funny, not even new being rich.
But we appreciate your effort, Bill. You're in there trying every time.
Don't you even say silicone around me.
I'll an ice cream silicone, please.
I said the mummy was wearing a pair of Gucci shoes.
Hey, Alexis, when does a mummy wear Gucci shoes? Right. Okay. So there we are at the end of round one. One to nothing is the score. We go to round two now. Avis, you may have A or B.
A, please.
A it is again. And everyone will play. Weird Willie is really weird. You've improved quite a bit. Here it is. It was bad enough when he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar, but today he got caught with his blank in the cookie jar.
You're the old
name. I'm the old name. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Go fishing.
Okay. Here we go, Avis. Weird Willie is really weird. He was bad enough when he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar, but today he got caught with his blank in the cookie jar.
I don't know if they'd both fit, but with his mistress.
Well. All right.
We need to know.
A rather imaginative answer.
Yes.
I can't do that reality.
She said mistress.
Caught with his mistress in the cookie jar.
It was a very large cookie jar, actually.
Yes. It was a ginger jar.
Yeah. No, he had broken up with his mistress, so he did the best he could. His whole arm was
his
in
arm.
The
cookie jar. Got caught with his arm.
Sorry,
okay.
Well, I started to say, but then I changed my mind. Thank I God. Said whole arm.
Whole arm,
yes. I went to the other end, his foot.
His foot, oh. Thank you very much. Now, Avis, doesn't look too good for you here. Brianne, what have you got?
I hate to break this to you, but tough noogies, Avis. Head.
Head. Bad enough when he got caught with his hand in the cookie jar, but today he got caught with his head in the cookie jar.
I love that.
What have you got there, Bill?
I think Dick Martin has been directing me on the Bob Newhart show too long. I said the foot also.
See? Two of those.
Great minds.
Think alike. It would be the opposite thing. Have you won yet? Head! All right, there it is. Head seems to have been the answer. That means Jesse Paul wins the game. Avis, it was a pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Gosh, it was very short, but yes, we'll have some gifts coming your way from Match Game 79.
Thank
Avis
you.
McDermott, there she is.
Bye.
Now I got a little message for America, and you're going to win more money right there.
Yes.
Essie is up here for her second time. She has $700. Again, she's going to try for the big money here in the Supermatch. We polled the studio audience, Essie, not too long ago and said, please write down your best answer to this. Blank for nothing. Number $500 for the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third.
Why didn't you see that?
Orson. Mercy, I got three wonderful ones.
Gee whiz, give me two.
Okay, you can take your choice of the two that I leave over. I'll say something for nothing.
Something for nothing.
Brett, Humphrey Bogart once said it to Jack Klugman. Nothing for nothing, kid.
Nothing for nothing.
I swear.
Bill. Hey, you got to stick with the winner. I'd say good for nothing.
Yeah. Good for nothing. Good for nothing, something for nothing, and nothing for nothing. Those are the three. Again, you have the option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own.
He wants another kiss.
Yes.
Good for nothing.
Oh.
I was hoping a little for more than that, but we win. We have a better.
Okay. We'll watch you very closely. Good for nothing is what she chooses, Bill's answer. Here we go. We're looking for it. Let's see if it's under the $100 number. All for nothing.
All or nothing at all.
That's my life, song. All for nothing.
Now we want good for nothing. Let's see the next one, please.
Something for nothing.
We have to go through this again.
Yes. Last good. Chance for good for nothing. Good. Slide the big one. You got it. Again, I see you've won another $500, and the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount or $5,000, but we're going to ask you to spin the wheel and see if you can double your money and play for $10,000. Good luck. Here we go. And in the gold star area will be a double. Gosh, it just... slid past.
I can't see.
It's electronically controlled, so it's just out of the area by a fraction of an inch.
We're doing pretty good so far, right?
Okay. $5,000 again.
Now try and
suppose you win the $5,000. You gave him a kiss for the $500. What? Well, I won't. I don't care.
Let's not get into that.
No, that's right. Okay. Good luck anyway. Let's swing around here a little bit there. All right. Here we go. Blank file. F-I-L-E. Blank file. Blank file. Blank file. Okay, now, Bill is finished. If you give us the answer that he's written on the card...
Let me get off my clothes first, because this is going to be good.
Is it?
This is going to be rated X. It's winning here.
All right. For the first rated X win on the show. No, we've got to get an answer from you first. If you give us the answer, you get the $5,000 and whatever else he wants to throw in. It's
so to speak.
Blank file.
It's a movie, and I can't remember the name of
We can't help you out here.
I got one for her. Can I give it to her?
No.
Of course I can't. That's silly.
Well,
I gotta say Rockford.
The Rockford file.
Yeah.
Rockford. Okay.
Oh no.
You were trying to think of another movie, a feature-length film, and not the TV show?
Yeah.
Okay, Bill, she says Rockford File will match it. What do you say?
There goes my evening. Nail file.
Nail file. Simple. You think she would have thought a nail file, wouldn't you think? You don't use a nail file? What do you use? Clippers?
I don't do anything.
Oh, you don't? Well, I see. Well, anyway, Essie, you've got a total of $1,200, and you're going to meet another player in a moment or so after we do a little business with America. No, it was not the Ipcris file. Now, the George Siegel was in that picture. What was the name of it? Well, anyway, we got to go. We'll see you tomorrow.
Think about it.
I'm Gene Faber. Join us next time.